Welcome to Nursing with Professor B. My name is Bridget. I have a master's degree in nursing education, and I am also a family nurse practitioner. Today, I will be explaining to you in a super easy, simple manner, what is the difference between sensitivity and specificity? Many people get confused, so if that's you, make sure you keep watching till the end, and after this video, you will understand it crystal clear, not muddy. All right, let's go. Before we get started, make sure you hit the like button, make sure that you subscribe, and make sure you turn on that notification bell. Let's go. Okay, sensitivity versus specificity. The importance of looking at these two things, sensitivity and specificity, is we use sensitivity and specificity in order to determine the validity of a test. So for example, I'll give you a very current example, right? They're trying to come up with point of care testing for coronavirus, right? Coronavirus test kits. Well, how sensitive and how specific are these tests means how good of a test is this, right? That's what validity means. It means how reliable is this test? Can we really listen to what this test is saying? I capitalized the V in sensitivity for a very specific reason. Sensitivity is the fraction of those with the disease correctly identified as positive by the test. So what does this mean? Even though tests can be made for bacterial infections, things like that, but the fact that sensitivity has a V in it, it helps me to remember that this has to do with those who have the virus, right? That's how I remember sensitivity. It measures those that have the virus. V for V, have the virus, okay? In other words, the sensitivity of a test correctly identifies those that do have the virus, right? So sensitivity means that the test correctly identifies those that have it. What does specificity mean? So I just thought of this as I was recording this. Fun fact, it didn't record the first time I did it, and then I just thought of it, and now I'm re-recording this. So yeah, the joys of technical issues. Okay, so specificity. Specificity is the fraction of those without the disease correctly identified as negative by the test. So basically, I don't have coronavirus, I'm tested for coronavirus, and I test negative. That's how specific it is. In other words, it correctly identifies those that do not have the disease, okay? The way that what I just thought of recently is this F here for I don't have the funk, right? So I'm going to name out a few things you don't want to have that you would be tested for. You don't have chlamydia, gonorrhea, bacterial vaginosis. That's, you don't have the funk, right? I'm using those because maybe it'll help drive it home if you're like, ooh, chlamydia, ooh, gonorrhea, right? So that's funk you don't want to have, right? So you don't have the funk, same thing. It shows who doesn't have the funk, aka coronavirus. That's what the specificity of a test means. It can correctly tell you this person doesn't have it and they truly do not have it. I repeat things multiple times because maybe if I say it in a different way or slightly different way, or you hear it three times, then it slowly starts to sink in. How do we calculate the sensitivity? Super simple, right? Here we have 100 total patients, right? We're taking 100 patients, we're gonna test them for coronavirus. Total diseased that have coronavirus are 20, right? 80 don't have coronavirus. So we took this test kit and 16 of them that have the disease tested positive. So that's a true positive. Now 4 of them that have coronavirus tested negative. So that's a false negative because they really do have it. So we do our little calculation in order to calculate sensitivity. We take those that were positive for the disease, that's 16, we put 16 on top of here, and we divide by all the diseased, right? And all the diseased, 16 plus 4 is 20, is 20. When we divide 16 divided by 20, we get 0.8. In order for us to convert to a percentage, we have to multiply that by 100. So imagine 0.8, right here, 0.8. When you multiply by 100, you move the decimal 2 places, 1, 2, you get 80%. So the sensitivity of this coronavirus test is 80%. That means that it will correctly identify those that have the disease 80% of the time. It means that it does not correctly identify 20% of patients that actually have coronavirus. Now, this is where students get confused. Is the specificity 20%? No, it is not, right? And I will show you it's a different calculation for that. So once again, the sensitivity for this test is 80%. It correctly identifies 80% of patients and does not identify 20% of the population. So how do we calculate specificity? Well, let's take our same example as before. We have 100 total patients, right? And 8 tested positive, and yet they don't have coronavirus. They're non-diseased. 72 tested negative, and they don't have the disease. Total, we have 80 patients, right? 80 plus 20 is 100. So we did our math right here. So we take the people that tested negative for coronavirus, which was 72, and we divide it by all non-diseased, which is 80. 72 divided by 80 gives you 0.9. We multiply that by 100 in order to get a percentage. So the decimal point would be here. You move it 2 spaces, 1, 2. You get a specificity of 90%. What that means is that in 90% of the situations, those that do not have coronavirus, they don't have the funk, will be tested as negative. And what that means is that in 10% of the situation, those that don't have coronavirus will test positive, right? Specificity measures those that don't have it. Sensitivity measures those that do have it. They have the virus. So I truly, truly hope that after this lesson, sensitivity and specificity is very clear, and you know how to calculate it also, and you know how to verbalize it. Thank you so much for watching. As always, make sure you hit the like button, make sure that you subscribe, and make sure you turn on that notification bell. When you like my videos, it helps them place higher, and other students can also benefit from the lessons, and so it helps other students. So be noble and help them out.